Hi students, already we started competitive. In previous video you saw some problems, examples, some concepts, and I suggested for you to write all formulas at one place, isn't it? Because whenever you saw the problem, which equation we are going to apply, it will be coming to know, so you can also remember well those equations. Okay, so now today's session we are continuing those competitive problems. I think yesterday we did up to page number 36. Example 12 is completed. Now we are going to solve example 30. See the problem. A particle is dropped from the top of a tower. Its displacement in the first 3 seconds and in the last second is the same. Find the height of the tower. See there, they give problem. A particle is dropped from some height. A particle is dropped from the top of a tower. That is, this is the top of the tower. From here they drop. Then dropped object means it will be coming downwards. And what they gave, its displacement in the first 3 seconds and in the last second is the same. Displacement in the first 3 seconds means it is taking some amount of time to reach some displacement in 3 seconds of time. Whenever it is coming downwards, in first 3 seconds it is covering some amount of displacement. This displacement, and what they gave next? In the last second, the displacement covered by the object is also same. Last second means, let us assume object is coming from here to here, t seconds or n seconds. Then, what is the distance covered in last second means, that is nothing but s n second. Okay? So, we don't know how much time it will take to reach here. So, that one we are taking it as n. So, s n is nothing but distance traveled in last second. So, in time 3 seconds, how much displacement is covered? This one and this one, both are equal there. Okay. So, first we are doing distance covered in first 3 seconds. 3 seconds means which formula we have to apply? S is equal to ut plus of at square. What is the initial velocity? U is equal to 0. Therefore, S in first 3 seconds is equal to 0 into 3 plus of G into 3 square. So, distance or displacement in first 3 seconds, this is nothing but we are taking S3 is equal to 0 into 3 0. So, G value generally will take 10 here, 10 by 2 into 9. So, S3 is equal to, so 95, 45 meters. Next, distance covered in the last second. Last second is what is the formula? Sn is equal to u plus a into n minus 1 by. What is n here means? How much time it is traveling to reach the ground, and last second what is the distance covered? Sn is equal to 0 plus g into n minus 1 by 2. So, Sn is equal to 10 into 2n minus 1 by 2. That is nothing but 5 into 2n minus 1. This is the distance traveled in last second. Now, they said both are equal. Both are equal, but what you have to find the height of the tower. So, what is the total height? Equate these two. So, they gave distance covered in first 3 seconds is equal to distance covered in last second. Here, last second means total time to reach the ground. We are taking, how much time is taking? N seconds. That N we will get from this equation. Then, where we have to substitute, we will see. So, S3 how much we got? 45. Sn how much we got? 5 into 2N minus. So, 45 is equal to 10n minus
then n is equal to 45 plus 5. Then n is equal to 10, n is equal to 50, n is equal to 50 by 10, that is equal to 5 seconds. What is this 5 seconds? How much time it is taking to reach the ground? How much time it is taking? N 5 seconds. So, in 5 seconds, object is coming downwards. Means it is covering how much displacement in 5 seconds? H distance. H displacement is covering. Therefore, we have to substitute S is equal to ut plus r at speed. S means how much distance it is covering? Height it is covering? H. U value? 0. In how much time it is coming to ground? 5 seconds. Plus r g 5 square. Then h is equal to g value. We will take 10. So in our classroom problems, we will take g value 10. So h is equal to 25 into 5. How much? 125 only. So 5 5s are 25, 5 2s are 10, 10 plus 2, 12. So 125 meters. That is the height of the tower. That is the example 13. Now we will see example 14. So this in this problem, you have to understand this concept. Distance covered in last second. I gave derivation for this in the previous video. See the example 14. So in the previous problem means example 13. The particle travels 9/25 of total distance in its last second. Find the time of fall and the height of the tower thereof. See there, a small change they give. What is the small change means? Object is dropped from top of the tower of height h we are assuming. So here they give in the last second 9/25 of total height in the last second. Find the time of fall and the height of the tower. Means how much time it is taking to reach the ground. And also they are asking, so what is the height of the tower? Same problem. This is the tower of height h. An object is dropped from here. It will be coming downwards. They give distance traveled in nth second. How much they give distance traveled in nth second? 9 by 25 of total distance. Total distance means how much distance it is covering? H. 9 by 25 of H. That is nothing but this distance. Distance covered in last second. How much time it is taking to reach the ground? Total time is nothing but N. Okay. So this time we have to calculate and this height we have to calculate. What is the formula? So generally, S is equal to ut plus half height. So to cover this total distance, that is nothing but height h, how much time it is taking? N seconds. Therefore, h is equal to initial velocity 0 into time value how much? N plus half a n square. Then h is equal to half a value g, half g n square. G value you can take 10, that is no problem. This is one equation you can take. So here n is how much time it is taking to reach the ground. So this height also we should calculate. To calculate this height, what we require? N will require. How we will be getting? We will see now. So distance covered in last second. What is the formula? Distance covered in last second, nth second. S n is equal to what is the formula? U plus a into n minus 1 by 2. So Sn is equal to u value 0 plus g into n minus 1 by 2. What is this Sn they give? Sn is nothing but 9 by 25 of h. 9 by 25 of h is equal to g into n minus 1 by 2. This h value how much we got from equation 1? So 9 by 25. H value how much? Half g n square is equal to g by 2 into 2n minus 1. 2 is LCM. I have taken like this. Here left side see g by 2 is there. Here also g by 2 is there. 9 into n square. 9 n square. This 25 we are setting this side. 25 into 2n minus 1. So 9 n square is equal to 25 into 50n minus 25. 9n square minus 50n plus 25 is equal to 0.
Have you ever seen this equation? So what is this equation? Quadratic equation. Ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. We have to find roots. Okay? How we will find, we see. Now see, this equation we got 9n square minus 50n plus 25 equal to 0. This is in the form of x square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. What is the root for this? X is equal to minus b plus or minus root b square minus 4ac by 2a. So we have to compare one by one. In place of b, how much is there here? B is equal to minus 50. A is equal to 9. This is A. This is 9. In place of C, 25. Substitute. In place of X, what is the real N? N is equal to minus B. Minus B value minus 50 plus or minus root B square. B square means what is B here? Minus 50 whole square minus 4. What is A? 9. What is C? 25. This is divided by 2A. 2. What is A value? A value is 9. Then N is equal to minus 50 minus 50 plus or minus root 50 minus 50 whole square. Minus whole square will become plus. 5 5s are 25. 2500. So 5 5 is 25. 0 square means 2 zeros. Minus. So 25 into 4, 100. Therefore 9 into 100, 900. Is divided by 18. So N is equal to 50 plus or minus root 2500 minus 900. How much you will get? 1600. Is divided by 18. So 50 plus or minus root 1600. How we will write? Root 1600 we can write it as 40 square, can we write? 4, 4, 16. 0 square, 100. Is divided by 18. Square root will be cancelled. Here what will be remaining now? 40. So one is 50 plus 40 by 18. Another one is 50 minus 40 by 18. 50 plus 40 means 90 by 18. Here this one 10 by 18. Which is possible among these two? This is possible. Why this is not possible? Means 10 by 18 is 0 point something. 0 point something means within the 0 point something object won't come downward. Therefore this value we no need to consider. This one we have to consider. So 90 by 18. So 90 by 18 means how much you will get? 90 by 18. 5 up. 5 times, so 5 is 40, 15, 9. So 5 seconds. Within 5 seconds, object will come downwards. Already we calculated, but this is different model they give. So what is the equation number 1 we got? H is equal to half g n square. So H is equal to half into 10 into 5 square. So again, we will get 5 into 25, that is 125 meters. So you got same answers, but problem is different. That model is different, this model is different. Next you can see example 15. In example 15 they give, a ball is thrown vertically upward with speed 40 meter per second. Simultaneously, another ball is dropped from same height, from a height of 200 meters in the same vertical line. When and where the balls will meet? Already we did one PU problem on this. Same concept, they give here competitive. So whenever you are solving competitive, so one shortcut will be there for this. Directly you can use that one also. Here they give initial velocity. Initial velocity, how much vertically projected body? Yeah, initial velocity is 40 meter per second. At the same time, another object is dropped from some height 200. So when and where two objects are going to meet? How much time it will take means shortcut is this one. H is equal to ut, or t is equal to h by u. How you will get this equation means already we derived one important question in PO. An object is dropped from some 400 meters height. At the same time, another object is projected vertically upwards with 100 meter per second. When and where they are going to meet means we got their 4 seconds height, 400 by 100. So this is also same, 200 by 40. How this equation came means those two equations we have taken. You can solve as homework or you can try. This is the shortcut. I am not deriving once again. You can see what you have written in your notes for that question. T is equal to h by u means what is h here? 200. U here 40. So 20 by 4. How much? So within 5 seconds. They will ask height. How much height it is traveling or after what height they are going to meet. After what height they are going to meet means. So this one if you are going to calculate x is equal. So s is equal to ub plus of 80 square. After how much time they are meeting? After 5 seconds. What is this s means? X. X is equal to what is u? 40. 40 into 5. A value will become minus t. Therefore, minus half into 10 into t square. T square means 5 square. So 200 minus 5 into 25. 200 minus 125. How much will get? That is the final answer, 75 meters. Okay, now see the example 16. For the example 16, a balloon carrying a stone is moving vertically upward with velocity 12 meters per second. When the balloon is at the height 65 meters, the stone is dropped. After how much time and with what velocity will it hit the will it strike the ground? In this, you should know one concept. Now I am going to explain the concept because the concept is not there for PU. So after explaining the concept, we will solve the problem. Now see the concept. What is the concept means? This is a tower of height h. Means you are standing on a building of height h. From here, always now onwards, up to now we discussed an object is dropped. Dropped means it will be coming downwards, initial velocity 0. Now what then it means? An object is projected vertically upwards with velocity u here. Then it is going upwards and again it is coming downwards. It is hitting the ground, not again to your hands. Okay, it is touching the ground. Means it is going upwards and again coming downwards. Then what is the total displacement it is going to cover? Which formula we are going to apply? We will see. Which formula means this formula? So time is there, height is there. Which formula? S is equal to ub plus of at square. So we have drawn object upwards. Then what is the total displacement means? Here upwards distance. Let us assume x. We will take upwards as positive, downwards as negative. So from point A to B, AB, what is the distance? X. From B to C, ground. B to C, what is the total displacement is going to be? This is nothing but from A to B is X. A to C is H. Therefore, what is the total displacement? X plus H. So upwards we have taken positive means, downwards we should take negative. Then what is the total distance or displacement it is going to cover? So S is equal to x minus x plus h. Then S is equal to x minus h. It is nothing but S is equal to minus h. So this formula we are going to use. When do you have to use means? Whenever the type of problems are coming. Now S is equal to minus h. U is u only. U t. A value, it is thrown upwards, therefore A should take minus, initially it is thrown upwards, therefore minus half g t square. This formula we are going to use. So this is the concept. After reaching some height, an object is dropped or an object is projected vertically upwards. In that example 16, balloon is going upwards. Isn't it? It is moving vertically upwards with velocity 12 meter per second. When the balloon is at a height of 65 meters, height how much they gave?
balloon is going upwards. So let us say the balloon is here at a height of 65 meters. From here, an object. What is there in the balloon? Stone they gave a stone. When the balloon is at height 65 meters, the stone is dropped. Stone is dropped means, I told you already, dropped means always we have taken an initial velocity 0. But here we should not take, because balloon is moving with what velocity, stone will come with that much velocity. Okay, you should not get confused with that. So how balloon will go, sir, if stone is there, that type of question you should not ask, because that is the problem we are going to solve. Okay, so now balloon is going upwards with velocity 12 meter per second. 12 only they give. 12 meter per second. Therefore, stone also will come with same velocity also. Therefore, initial velocity u is equal to 12 meter per second. Now, this is similar to this concept. Now, in place of minus is what we should means for this concept, we should take this formula. Therefore, minus h is equal to ut minus of gt square minus 65 is equal to u value 12 t minus of 10 t square. So minus 65 is equal to 12 t minus 5 t square. You can bring this side. 5 t square minus 12 t minus 65 is equal to minus will become plus, plus will become minus is equal to 0. Again you got this model. Ax square plus bx plus c. What is the formula? A x square plus b x plus c is equal to 0. What is a here? 5. B here minus 12. C here minus 65. So what is the formula? X is equal to, that is b is equal to minus b plus or minus root b square minus 4ac by 2a. What is minus b? B value is again minus 12. Therefore, minus of minus 12 plus or minus root b square. What is b again? Minus 12 whole square minus 4 into, what is a? A is nothing but 5. 5 into, what is c? C is nothing but minus 65. So is divided by 2 into a value. So a value is nothing but 5. So 12 plus or minus root 12 whole square. Minus will become plus. 12 plus or 144 minus 4, 5, 20. 20 into 65. Minus will become plus. 20 into 65 is divided by 10. That is nothing but 12 plus or minus root 144 plus 65 2s. How much? 5 2s? 10. 6 2s are 12. 12 plus 1? 30. Correct only? So 30, 100 is divided by 10. So x is equal to rt is equal to 12 plus or minus. So 144 plus 1300. How much? 4, 4, 1 plus 4. Correct only? So 1300 plus 1444. So you can calculate the square root of 1444. Then you can subtract. Approximately you will be getting, how much? Square root of 1444, 38. So you will be getting 12 plus or minus 38 is divided by 10. Again, 12 plus 38 by 10, comma 12 minus 38 by 10. So time won't be negative. Therefore, you can remove that one. So 12 plus 38, how much? 8 plus 2, 10. 3 plus 1, 5 up, total 50 by 10. Again, time how much you got? 5 seconds. So what they are asking in example 16, they are asking what is the time taken, how much time it is taking? 5 seconds. So second time you won't take, why? Because it is coming in negative. Next what they are asking, with what velocity it is coming, sorry, it is striking the ground. With what velocity means, you will be having two formulas, v square minus v square equal to 2as or v is equal to u plus at. And the time you got already, you came to know. Directly you can substitute, you will get the answer. Okay? I am not solving that. I think you can solve. Next, example 17. A particle is thrown vertically upward with speed 45 meter per second. Find the
distance covered by the particle in the fifth second of its journey. They are asking distance covered by the particle in the fifth second. So fifth second, how much distance it is going to cover? So what is the initial velocity they gave? An object is thrown with 45 meter per second. So in the fifth second, what is the distance covered? It is going upwards, not downwards. Okay, it is going upwards means first, how much time it is taking to reach maximum height we have to find. Why? Because is it taking 5 seconds to reach maximum height or not? Because they are asking in fifth second. Therefore, so what is the time taken by the object to reach the maximum height? At maximum height, what will be 0? Final velocity will be 0. Correct? Okay? At maximum height, what is 0? Final velocity 0. To reach the maximum height, how much time it will take? What is the formula? Time of Sn u by g. Time taken by the object to reach the maximum height, or time taken by the object to reach the maximum height, where its final velocity is going to become 0. So what is u value they gave? 45. G value generally will take 10. Therefore, 4.5 seconds. So it is taking time. After 4.5 seconds, it will be at maximum. But they are asking in fifth second. Fifth second means how you do? It is taking 4.5 seconds only towards total height. Then what we have to take means fifth second means from where to where it is going. Let us assume this is 4.5 means 4 will be here. 4 to 4.5. 4 to 4.5. That is not nothing but A to B it is going. 4 to 4.5. 4 to 4.5 means almost like half second. So 4 to 4.5, this distance if you want to calculate means what is the velocity at this point? This is 4 seconds. What is velocity at this point? We don't know. Right? Because velocity is going, decreasing. We can find, but presently we don't know. But what is the velocity here? And final velocity is going to be 0. And you have to understand this one. A to B, how much distance? B to A also same distance. But we can calculate easily from B to A. A to B, how much time it is taking? B to A also it will take same time. Isn't it? A to B, it is going upwards. This is A. This is B. A to B, it is going upwards. But from B to A, it is coming downwards. And as it is coming downwards, here final velocity will become initial velocity. That is nothing but 0. How much time it is taking? Half second. Okay? So, A to B, B to A is same. Therefore, first we calculate B to A. Next we will get obviously A to B is also same. B to A distance. B A is equal to U plus A to U B plus half A T square. So, B A is equal to 0 plus half G. T value how much? 1 by 2 whole square. G value 10 by 2 into 1 by 4. How much you got? So 5 by 4. 5 by 4 means 1.25 meters. AB is 1.25 meters means, sorry, BA is 1.25 meter means AB also 1.25. Therefore, distance covered. This is in half second. So in next half second also, because 4 to 4.5 is 1.25. 4.5 to 4, total time, 1 second is 10. Therefore, total time, total distance is nothing but 1.25 plus 1.25. That is the answer. We have to understand carefully because whenever they are asking distance covered, whenever it is projected vertically across, in that case, you have to see first how much time it is taking to reach the maximum height. Why? Because 5th second means where it will be coming, we don't know. Okay? So, next, applications of differentiation. They give test your knowledge questions. You can try to practice. Already some problems already we discussed in our general class. Next we are going for applications of differentiation in physics. In that mainly I am saying about acceleration. Remaining all you came to know. Why? Because this concept we are going to use. A is equal to what is the acceleration definition? Rate of change of velocity. dv by dt. Velocity definition. Rate of change of displacement, ds by dt or dx by dt.
dt. So we can use anything. So sometimes you write ds by dt, sometimes you write dx by dt. Here x or s is nothing but displacement. If this is the answer, so this problem, this one, they can rearrange like this. So dv by ds into ds by dt. What is ds by dt? We can write means we divide it and multiply with ds. What we can write? Ds by dt we can write it as v. Therefore, v into dv by ds. So this equation, a is equal to v into dv by ds. So this equation we are going to use in some problems. Now we are going for differentiation. Already I get differentiation equation. So derivative of x power n, that is nothing but n into x power n minus 1. Derivative of x power n with respect to time, n into x power n minus 1 dx by dt. Here what will be coming? Dx. Okay. So the, on these two equations, we are going to get some problems. See the example 18. Already we did that model in our classroom. Now it is going to become little bit easy for you. A particle is moving in a straight line such that its displacement at any time t is given by 4t cube plus 3t square. S is equal to 4t cube plus 3t square. Find the velocity and acceleration in terms of t. 4t cube plus 3t square. 4t cube plus 3t square. What is this one? Yes. What is S here? Displacement. Displacement from the gear. A particle is moving in a straight line such that its displacement is equal. S is equal to 4t cube plus 3t square. Then what they are asking? Velocity and acceleration in terms of t. What is velocity equation? V is equal to, what is formula? Ds by dt. So d by dt of, what is S? 4t cube plus 3t square. Expand this one. D by dt of, first we have to write 4t cube. Next we have to write 3t square. 4 is constant. Write it outside. 4 into dt cube by dt plus 3 into dt square by dt. So this one. In place of x, what is there here? T. In place of n, what is there here? 3. Therefore, this formula we have to apply. So 4 is 4 only. So in place of n, 3. 3 into x power n minus 1. 3 into t power 3 minus 1. So here dx by dt, here dt by dt, I am not writing that one, it is going to become 1. Next, this is 3 into, 3 I wrote, so in place of x, 3 is there, in place of n, 2 is there, therefore 2 into t power 2 minus 1, so 12 t square plus 3 into 2, 6, 2 minus 6 t, this is nothing but velocity. Velocity in terms of time. Now they ask acceleration in terms of time. What is the acceleration formula? A is equal to dv by dt. This one. A is equal to dv by dt. What is v? 12 t square plus 60. V by dt of 12 t square plus 60. Then expand this. V by dt of 12 t square plus v by dt of 60. Write it 12 outside. 12 into dt square by dt plus 6 into dt by dt. So 12 into, so apply same formula. 2 into t power 2 minus 1 plus 6. Dt by dt is 1. So 12 into 24t plus 6. This is nothing but acceleration in terms of time. Okay. So very easily you can get once the mathematics derivatives part completed. Next, see example 9. This is also same model, but they give time here. Once you can read the problem, a particle moves along a straight line such that its displacement S is equal to alpha t cube plus beta t square plus gamma. S is equal to alpha t cube plus beta t square plus gamma, where t is the time and alpha beta are some constants. Find the initial velocity and the velocity here t is equal to 2 seconds. Here they ask, find the initial velocity. Find the initial velocity means you should take time as 0. But here what they give? Displacement they give.
So first what we have to calculate?
Velocity.
What is the velocity equation? V is equal to ds by dv. So d by dt of what is s? Alpha t cube plus beta t square plus gamma. Here alpha, beta, gamma are constants. So differentiate this one. So d by dt of alpha t cube plus d by dt of beta t square plus d by dt of gamma. Alpha write it outside because it is constant. Alpha dt cube by dt plus beta dt square by dt plus what is derivative of constant? So I gave this formula. Derivative of x power n with respect to t, n into x power n minus 1 dx by dt. And what is derivative of constant? Derivative of constant is always 0. Therefore, this term is going to become 0. Now apply the formula. Alpha into 3 into t power 3 minus 1. Dt by dt is going to become 1. Plus beta into 2 into 2 power t power 2 minus 1. What is this one? Velocity. V is equal to 3 alpha t square plus 2 beta t. Totally, this is the equation for velocity. Now what they ask me is initial velocity and velocity at 2 seconds. What is the initial velocity means? At t is equal to 0. Velocity is nothing but initial velocity. Substitute t is equal to 0. Velocity at t is equal to 0. In this you can substitute. 3 alpha into 0 square plus 2 beta into 0. So velocity, initial velocity is 0 meter per second. Next they ask velocity at 2 seconds. At 2 seconds what is the velocity? V is equal to t is equal to 2 seconds. T is equal to 2 seconds, substitute t is equal to 2 here. 3 alpha 2 square plus 2 beta into 2. What will you get? 2 square means 4. 4 into 3. 12 alpha plus 2 into 2. 4. So this is 12 alpha plus 4 beta is the velocity at 2 seconds. Initial velocity 0. See the example 20. A particle is moving in a straight line such that s is equal to t cube plus t cube minus. They get a little bit big equation. So we are going to write. Example 20. S is equal to t cube minus 3t square plus 3t plus 2. Isn't it? That is the displacement. A particle is moving in a straight line such that s is equal to t cube minus 3t square plus 3t plus 2, where s is the displacement. Find the velocity at 2 seconds, acceleration at 3 seconds. Velocity and acceleration is 0. Acceleration when? Velocity is going to become 0. So first we will find velocity and acceleration in terms of equations. Okay, so velocity is equal to, what is the equation? Ds by dt. So d by dt of t cube minus 3t square plus 3t plus 2. Okay, while solving you can write, I am writing directly t cube means 3t square minus 60 plus 3. This is going to become 0 because already I did 2 times by expanding. Now I am doing directly. So if you want means here you can pause. You can write this like this expansion. Whether you got same equation or not, you can check once. 3t square minus 60 plus 3 is going to become, and last term is going to become 0. Then V is nothing but 3t square minus 60 plus 3. So this is the velocity. Next we have to find acceleration. A is nothing but dv by dt. So d by dt of 3t square minus 60 plus 3. This is acceleration. So 3t square differentiation. I am writing once again directly, 60 minus 6 plus 0. Then A is equal to 60 minus 6. So by using these two equations, what they ask, first you can say A. What they ask A? Velocity at 2 seconds. Velocity at 2 seconds means, in this equation, velocity at the time t is equal to 2 seconds. In place of t, what I have to substitute? 2. 3 into 2 square minus 6 into 2 plus 3. So 2 square means 4. 4 3 is 12 minus 12 plus 3. Therefore, so 3 meter per second. This is velocity at 2 seconds. Next, what they ask? Acceleration at? Acceleration at 3 seconds. Not 2 seconds. Acceleration at 3 seconds. A is equal to t is equal to 3 seconds. So A is equal to, sorry, A at 3 seconds. Now in place of t, what I have to substitute? 3. 6 into 3 minus 6. So 18 minus 6. 18 minus 6 means how much? 12. So 12 meter per second square. That is nothing but acceleration. Correct only. 18 minus 6. 12 meter per second square. That is B. Next, see what they asked. Velocity when acceleration is 0. Velocity when acceleration is 0 means they are asking velocity at acceleration is 0. When acceleration is 0, what is going to happen? This equation you are going to take. So A is equal to 0 means that implies 60 minus 6 equal to 0. 60 minus 6 equal to 0 means 60 equal to 6. Then t is equal to how much? 6 by 6. 1 second. So this one you have to substitute in this equation. Then velocity b is equal to. So velocity we are substituting. I am not doing here. There I am doing. You can check once. Time t, how much we got? 1 second. So v is equal to what is the equation? 3 t square minus 3t square minus 6t plus 3. So at t is equal to 1 second, acceleration is 0 because they are asking velocity at acceleration is 0. Velocity at acceleration 0 means at 1 second acceleration is going to become 0. Therefore, time we are going to substitute 1. 3 into 1 square minus 6 into 1 plus 3. So 3 minus 6 plus 3. How much are you getting? 3 plus 3 is 6, 6 minus 6. 0. So velocity is 0 at acceleration is 0. Now next they ask acceleration when velocity is 0. Just reverse way out. So this one we need whenever acceleration is 0, this equation will be equated for 0. Now they are asking when velocity is 0, what is the acceleration? Now we have to equate this velocity equation for 0. So v is equal to 0 means if v is equal to 0, 3t square minus 6t plus 3 equal to 0. So this equation you can, quadratic equation you can change. T square minus 2t plus 3 is equal to 1. Plus 1 is equal to 0. I have taken 3 common, 3 i's and right side. Correct only? T square minus 2t plus 1 is equal to 0. How will you write this equation? T square minus 3 plus 1 is going to become t is common, t minus 1. Here what is common? So t is common, t minus 1. Here we can write t minus 1. Here how we will write? T common. Can we write 1 minus t here? How will we write this equation? Minus t minus t. So minus 1 into 1, 1 into 1, 1. Correct only? Here we are taking minus 1 comma, then t plus, sorry, t minus 1 is going to become 0. If you have taken t minus 1 comma, again you are getting t minus 1 equal to 0. Therefore, this equation you can write a square plus b square minus 2ab. Therefore, a minus b whole square. Like this also we can write. Both are going to be same. Isn't it? So, a minus b whole square. If you apply same thing, you will get. If you have taken comma like this also, you will get. t minus 1 whole square equal to 0 means t minus 1 equal to 0 and t is equal to 1 second means velocity is going to become 0 at t is equal to 1 second. So where velocity is going to become 0, they are asking acceleration. Acceleration at time t is equal to 1 second, because at time t equal to 1 second velocity is going to become 0. What is the acceleration formula? So, A equal to 60 minus 6, TL value 1. Therefore, 6 minus 6.
that is also going to become 0.
Okay, so this is end of example 20. See the example 21. So in example 21, a particle is moving such that velocity is given by v is equal to root 2 lambda s, where lambda is constant, s is displacement. Then they are asking what is the acceleration, isn't it? So what is the acceleration means, what you have to do, you have to differentiate. How you differentiate means, because you give a is equal to dv by dt, isn't it? Another formula is also there. How I give a is equal to, this one only we wrote like this, dv by ds into ds by dt. So dv by ds into ds by dt we wrote as v into dv by ds. Why I wrote that equation, you will be getting, we will see once. So differentiate this one. A is equal to d by dt of, what is v? Root 2 lambda s. In this, lambda is constant. 2 is constant. Therefore, we won't do differentiation for 2 lambda. We will do only for s. So write this one as d by dt of root 2 lambda into root s. Can we write? The root 2 lambda is constant, write it outside. Then a is equal to root 2 lambda. Root 2 lambda d by dt of s power 1 by 2. S can be, means root can be written as whole power 1 by 2. What is the formula? Derivative of x power n with respect to t is equal to n into x power n minus 1 dx by dt. This formula we are going to apply. In place of x, here s is there. In place of t only there. But in place of n, half is there. Okay? So a is equal to root 2 lambda. In place of n, half. Half into, in place of x, s. S into n minus 1. Power n minus 1. By 1 by 2 minus 1 dx by dt. Here in place of x, what is there? Yes. Therefore, ds by dt. Correct only? So, next step. Root 2 lambda into 1 by 2 into s power. 1 by 2 minus 1. So, 1 by 2 minus 2. If you have taken 2 LCM. So, ds by dt. How you write ds by dt? As velocity. Can we write ds by dt as velocity? Already this b, we can know, they give. What is b? Root 2 lambda s. Substitute that. So, a is equal to root 2 lambda by 2. Root 2 lambda by 2. 1 minus 2. Minus 1. So, s power minus 1 by 2. Into, in place of b. How much we can substitute in place of b? Root 2 lambda s. Currently they gave root 2 lambda s. Substitute that. Then you will be getting acceleration in terms of equation. Otherwise you can remove this one. How you remove means root 2 lambda by 2 into root 2 lambda s. I wrote this one and this one. So this one can be written as s power whole power minus 1 by 2 can be written as s power 1 by 2. So root 2 lambda by 2. So root 2 lambda s by root s. So this is also root s, this is also root s. These two will be cancelled. So root 2 lambda into root 2 lambda is divided by 2. Root x into root x. How will we write? Root x into root x, x. X can be written as root x into root x. Therefore, you will write root 2 lambda into root 2 lambda. How will we write? 2 lambda by 2. Then a is equal to lambda. You got? So a is equal to lambda. So you may feel all these are like mathematics. So physics is nothing but like mathematics only it would be. So all these are calculations. These are related to mathematics only. So don't feel this is nothing but difficult. So once you get to know differentiation, all these are going to become very easy fun. Okay. So up to now we discussed some problems on differentiation, some problems on equations. नेक्स्ट थ्री प्रॉब्लम्स देखे ऑन द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ इंटीग्रेशन. सो डिफरेंशिएशन फर्स्ट पीयू मैथमेटिक्स टीचर्स विल स्टार्ट व्हेनेवर द लेसन इज गोइंग टू बी स्टार्टेड इन मैथमेटिक्स. लिमिट्स एंड डेरिवेटिव्स विल बी देयर फॉर. सो दिस इंटीग्रेशन कॉन्सेप्ट यू विल बी गेटिंग इन मैथमेटिक्स ओनली बट इन सेकेंड पीयू बट वी आर गोइंग टू अप्लाई नाउ ओनली. ओके सो up to now I introduced for you integration, sorry differentiation. Now we are going to discuss about integration. What is integration and definition of this, they will, the mathematics people will give, but here we are going to give direct formula how to do integration. So this symbol we are calling it as integral. How the symbol name means from the summation S. So if you along it, yes, that is on the integral symbol. So about this introduction of this is second PU you will get, but here we have to apply this equation. How we are going to apply, I will say for you. Integral x power n dx, integral x power n dx formula is x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. Extra they will write mathematics, they will write plus constant, here you won't write. Okay, this is the formula for integral x power n dx is equal to integral, sorry, x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. This is nothing but integral x power n value. So, between the limits they will do this one. Between the limits means, it is x is varying from where to where. Where to where means, a to b, from initial velocity to final velocity. From time t is equal to 0 to, from time up to time 5 seconds. So, varying they will. At the time, how this formula will become? X power n dx is equal to x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. Between the limits they will say a b. This limit will say lower limit. This limit will say upper limit. So what is the formula of this one means? First we have to substitute upper limit always. B power n plus 1 by n plus 1 minus a power n plus 1 by n plus 1. So integral x power n dx without limits. X power n plus 1 by n plus 1. So with limits, this value is this one. So these two formulas you have to remember. I will give one or two examples. So integral x square dx. Integral x square dx. Apply this formula in place of x, x only. X in place of n, how much is there? 2. Therefore, 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1. That is nothing but x cube by 3. Sometimes there will be same equation like this. Integral 3x square dx. Here 3 is constant. At the time 3 you should write outside. 3 integral x square dx. 3 x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. That is nothing but 3x cube by 3. That is nothing but x cube. This is simple problem on integral x square. So same between the limits there will be p cube dt. Integral t cube dt. So your time is varying from 0 to 2 seconds. Let us assume. I am doing second one. A to B. So whenever they have given like this, how we have to solve? Here in place of x, what is there? T is there. So in place of dx, dt is there. Therefore, same formula, how we are going to do means t power 3 plus 1 by 3 plus 1. Correct one? X power n plus 1 by n plus 1. Therefore, in place of x, t is there. In place of n, 3 is there. Between the limits, 0 to a to b. Here they have given 0 to. In place of t, here I substituted b. In place of x. Now, in place of t, 2, 3 plus 1, 4. 2 power 4 by 4 minus lower limit here, 0. 0 power 4 by 4. Correct only 3 plus 1, 4. So 2 power 4 by 4 minus 2 power 4 means how much? 16. 16 by 4. That is nothing but. Now integral t cube dt between limits 0 to 2 is value is 4. Why I said these two means? Because we are going to apply this integration concept in example 22, 23, 24. Now I am giving example 22. So see the 22 ones. A particle is moving in a straight line under acceleration a is equal to kt, where k is constant. Find the velocity in terms of t. the motion starts from rest. What does it mean? Initial velocity is zero. What they are asking? Find the velocity in terms of t. Find the velocity in terms of t means they are asking final velocity. What they give? Acceleration a is equal to kt. A is equal to kt. Where a is, k is nothing but constant. A is equal to kt they give. Isn't it? It starts from rest. Starts from rest means initial velocity 0. At a time t is equal to 0. Initial velocity 0 at time t is equal to 0. T is equal to 0 means from where it is starting. It is starting at t is equal to 0 and it is taking some amount of time t. Within this time it is gaining velocity v. Now velocity is changing from u to v. Time is changing from 0 to t. Understood? Time is changing from 0 to t. You are coming from home to college. So at home at 0 seconds representation. So by coming for college it is taking 30 minutes. Okay? 0 to 30. Time is varying. Your velocity is 0. You started from this. Finally you are gaining some velocity in bus. Okay, that is final velocity. So velocity is changing from initial to final, u to v. Time is changing from 0 to t. That is nothing but initial time 0, final time t. So what we came to know, a is nothing but acceleration. We came to know a is nothing but dv by dt, rate of change of velocity. Dv can be written as dv is equal to kt dt. So this is the equation. For this equation, to get velocity, we have to do integration on both sides. Integration on both sides. In shortcuts, they write integration on both sides. If you want to do differentiation, differentiation on both sides. But here we are doing integration. So integral dv is equal to integral kt dv. Here velocity changing from where to where? 0 to v. 0 to v. Time is varying from where to where? 0 to t. So I get the formula for it. So another formula you should give for this. What is integral dv? So what is integral dx? Integral dx is nothing but x. Otherwise integral 1 dx they will say in mathematics. Integral 1 dx is also x. Integral dx also x. Therefore integral dv you can write it as v between the limits 0 to v. K is constant. K integral 0 to t t dv. Here t dv means t power how much is there? 1. Apply this formula. X power n dx. So what you will be getting? K into t power 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 1 between the limits 0 to t. Here upper limit if we substitute v minus 0. Upper limit minus lower limit. Here upper limit t. T only. Therefore t power 1 plus 1 by 1 plus 1 minus 0 power 1 plus 1. Therefore what you will get? V is equal to k into. Yes, to substitute t in place of t only. Therefore you don't need to write anything. T only you can write. T power 2. 1 plus 1 2 by 2 minus 0 power 2 by 2. 0 square by 2. Why? Because second time in place of t 0 you have to substitute. So V is equal to of k. This is velocity in terms of time after some amount of time. Now you can try as homework example 23 and 24. Otherwise, we will solve in next class. Homework is example 23 and 24. Don't copy directly what is there in the book. You can try one by step by step like this. You will be getting. Okay.